The wind was refreshing. It was the best time to enjoy the evening breeze. Just as I stepped outside the dorm, I saw familiar people standing near the bench. Rin and Kud. Yeah, I was expecting Kud. We met her in this location, so we're gonna see her in this location, clearly. Oh, yeah. I was just freaking out. I was like, why is she with Rin down? And it's like, oh, yeah, they were roommates for a bit, weren't they? It happened, like, near the start of the recording. Rin just randomly popped up when Masada was going on about muscles. And she was just freaking gone after that. Rin and Kud, it was unusual to see them together, so I approached them. What are you doing?
Rikika, 大丈夫か?
I'm used to it, this, so I'm fine. So, what are you up to?
特に何もしてない。 こんにちは, Naoe-san!
Rin was holding a cat in her arms. Its name was Audrey, I think. Many more cats were rubbing against her legs, seeking her attention and purring. I bet that was written out in katakana, because that's not... That's a non-Japanese name. Oh, never mind. It actually somehow has... Wait, never mind. Wait, I'm confused. Is that the line? Is that the previous line? Alright. I was wondering that. I was like, oh, yeah. Yeah. So, it'd be this, I guess? Order. And I guess the lines kind of, you know, emphasize the drawn-out pronunciation. But anyways, that just says, you know, konnichiwa, which is good afternoon. Riki-san, because that's just the kanji address in his name. Do you like cats, good? I see, what's that? Actually, I think I know the answer already. Yes, for it is very obvious. Well, is it very obvious? It's just like, yeah, my favorite animal? Newts. It's like, well, that's very random. Dogs. He's more of a dog person. You know, it's like sometimes I always kind of see myself as a dog person, but then again, I guess I'm more of a cat person since I always have a cat in my room all the time. I mean, the cat's right in front of me, just sleeping. He's like, always in my room, man. I don't know who's blaming it out of me. It's just like, I would just be lying there with a laptop, and she'd just leap up onto my chest. She did that earlier, and she, like, clawed into my trousers, and you know how cats can be clumsy and get stuck? It's like, ow! I know, anytime, like, I leave the room, that's a few times where she actually leaves the room, usually. Is when I walk out to do something. It's just like, I will follow you for no particular reason, and then return to annoy you in your own room when you're trying to just do basically anything. Well, yeah, thanks. Thanks for what? No, seriously, thanks for what? It's like, what a quick answer, and I absolutely correct you. Why are you saying thanks? Looking at her, it seemed like she belonged to the same species. You own a dog?
Hontaku, oji-sama no ie toyu imi desu yo.
Really? What do you mean? At work? Those two were clearly names of watchdogs. Kind of think of it, I'd heard something about disciplinary committee members getting themselves reliable partners for patrolling around the girls' dorm. sure take things seriously, don't they? It's like, yeah, we got dogs. Anyone breaking any rules will be mauled to death. Well, not to that extreme, but you will get pretty fucked up. Stop scratching, cat. You always do that. So that reason is that? Yeah. You know, it's interesting, isn't it? Rin is clearly shy around people she isn't too familiar with. Like, talking to them and all that. She seems perfectly fine with Kud, but then again, they were roommates for a bit, so I guess they got used to each other. Are you going to convey it to them through Monpetit, Rin? She said while taking out a can of cat food. It won't translate anything. She walked away holding the cat in her arms. Where's she going, carrying a cat? Oh, I see. And fast as lightning, you caught it?
Yeah.
She waved her hands in denial. She took a paper bag that lay on the bench and placed it underneath it. Wait. She took a paper bag that lay on the bench and placed it underneath it. What? Oh, placed it underneath the bench. No. And? Because the wind blew and the paper bag made a rustling sound. That instant? I don't really get it. Wait, the cat just went inside the bag. I get what she means, so I very much do. Cats, they love, for whatever reason, to try to fit into bags, boxes. They'll just shove their head into anything like that. You'll just be like, my own business, suddenly you just look out of the corner of your eye, cat's got a freaking bag on his head, and just like, oof. Well, it's like, you know, like bottles of water, for example. You know, when it comes in a pack, and it has the packaging, not like those, I don't know what you'd call it. Like the packaging for it, but it's not like the type of packaging, like, you know, has animals that get like heads stuck in it kind of thing. Nothing like that. I mean, like, you know, a package that covers all the water. Is this making any sense? It's just like the cat would just dive right through it. It's just like, what the hell are you doing, cats? And basically anything square shaped, they will try to fit into it. Even if it is ridiculously small, they will try to fit in it. They just love shit like that for some reason. And why is that? Because they like cramped places? And I could see it that way. I mean, the way cats kind of pounce at bags. It's like, you said, with, like, you know, the bacteria that comes with water, you dive in that kind of way. She nodded emphatically. I see, so that's why you were with Rin? She looked delighted. Okay, see you, good. Her mantle swayed around as she left. I saw her off. Cat and a dog, huh? That really was how Rin and Kud appeared to me. My stomach growls loudly. I should go grab some dinner soon. Oh yeah, stop it. She's always scratching. Should go grab some dinner soon.
Yoshi, tension agatte kita na.
Are we doing this again?
Kyou mo itto yaru ka?
Once again, Kyousuke came over when the night fell.
学生のくせにすでに夜型とは、さすが Kyousuke としか言いようがねえぜ。
Can it be you're going to make Rin search for members again?
こいつは、そのつもりだぞ。
We do this every night and we always fail. Why are we still doing this? Kengo replied in a tired voice as he sat down. But we already got plenty of girls on the team, isn't it enough?
No. そういやそうだな。でも、リンはやる気満々で寮の前でスタンバってるしな。
But isn't she like the only one overflowing with enthusiasm?
じゃあ、別のミッションに変えるか。リン、聞こえるか、オーバー。
オーバー言うな、オーバ
ー。I thought they were over the over at this point though. What happened to that?
本日よりミッションを変更する。夜の校舎に謎の生命体が潜んでいるという噂だ。宿直の教師にも被害者が出ている。
What is this?
その危険生物を駆逐せよ。ミッションスタート。
ミッションスタート。
いやだ、オーバー。
行け、オーバー。
怖いわ、オーバー。
ちなみにな。
She says in that tone, over.
宿直の先生たちの話によると、緊急食としている煮魚の缶詰が大量に消えてなくなってるらし
い。
やつらを倒せば、それが手に入る。
うん、やる。と言うとでも思ったかバカ兄貴め、余計怖いわ、オーバ
ー。でも、煮魚の缶詰だぞ。こいつは猫たちの大好物に違いない。奴ら喜ぶだろうな。
うん、やる。
Rin, you really will? Should I? Nine.Stop her! Oh, you don't need to do that anymore, Rin. I shouted into the phone. It's gotta be dangerous. A few guys have already been hurt by it. And I'm just picturing this, this mysterious creature is actually an octopus. It's just somehow just been wandering around stealing all these cans, and anyone who gets in its way.It just sucker punches them quite literally. I'll give you some.
なら戻る。オーバー。
早いな、おい。
本当にそれだけに釣られてたんだな。
で、何なんだ、その謎の生命体って。
さあ。
Kengo got to his feet.
どうした、ケンゴッチ。
大人だけならいいが、生徒にも。被害が及びかねないからな。
We could hear his determination from his words. He was going to destroy that monster.
そら首相なこったな。
And the Kengo left, Rin slid into the room and sat down next to him.
もっぺち?
No, I don't have them right now.
なに?
さあ、Kengoの戦いが始まるぞ。
見えるのか?
こんなこともあろうかと別電源を使った予備マイクを仕込んでおいた。そっちに切り替える。
I mean, what the hell? You plan for everything, Kyousuke. You secretly like Aizen from Bleach. You give off that villainous look whenever you battle. We listened intently to the sounds coming over the modified cell phone.Oh yeah, I know what the unknown life form is now, I remember it.
使うか。確かに変わった。
It's clearly a bird.
あるものは使おう。使えるものだな。どれ、使うか。確かに変わった。
will that be enough? Probably not. It's kind of ridiculous. It's like they go on about this unknown life form, and then he's just like, yeah, that's just like, you know, bull, right? There's nothing to it. No, there's actually something there. Holy shit, he's kicking its ass. I remember the origin story on it, though. Kengo is victorious.
Sasuga Kengo da na.
Yep, he's so reliable.
So, Kengo no yatsu sugee kakkoii janai ka! Jealousy!
He just beat the shit out of some big ass bird.
Mizukara sugoi makei no puri o roteii shiteru na, koitsu.
Let's leave him alone, he'll have forgotten by tomorrow. And thus we wrapped up the incidents. And so the night went on. So if I hadn't stopped Rin, would she have ended up having to fight him instead? Possibly. She probably wouldn't have been able to handle it. May 19th. Let me just check. Walkthrough.
さて、今日は土曜日だ。
Yeah, there will be a choice on this day that is relevant to the walkthrough. Yeah. Everyone was eyeing me glad at Kyousuke as if he'd said something overly obvious.
授業は午前で終わり、午後からは目いっぱいメンバー探しができるな。
Everyone did their best to ignore him.
リキ、好きだぜ。
His sudden words broke my composure and I turned to look at him.
さすがはリキだ。リキはすげえな。
It's just like he plays along and just goes, I love you too, Kyousuke.
見習いよ、みんなも。
It's like, Kyousuke sounds a bit Kyousuke to me. I realized that I'd fallen into his trap. Asaro, I love you.
え?マジかよ?
As expected of you, Asaro, you're amazing. You're so eager about looking for members, I absolutely love you.
Kengo.
好きだぜ。俺は嫌いだ。
No sold it.
男に振られて気性いやつだな。悪いな、リン。実はリンの方が好きなんだ。気性い?寄ってくんな。さすがだな、リンは。気性いから話しかけるな。
Looks like Matsuo and I will be the only ones looking for members. Morning! What is this music? Have we heard this track yet? I don't think so.
Naoe-san, ohayou gozaimasu!
Are you gonna be the next member?
Riki-kun, osoi!
Or are you gonna be the next member?
Chikoku shichau yo!
What about you, Sayu-san? Is it okay not returning to your own classroom? Under the clock, it was just about time for class to start.
Hidoi! リキ君が仲間外れにするよ!
Orchestrize or not, you're still in a different class and should get back.
いいじゃん! 別にさ、ホームルームは自分のクラスで受けなきゃいけないなんて拘束はないよ!
It's common sense. I wouldn't bother writing one down.
遅刻はいけないと思います! クドコンにまで説教されてしまった。
For some reason, she looked pleased with herself.
よし、こうなったらユイネを呼ぶしかないな!
Hey, can you run that by me again?
よし、こうなったらユイネを呼ぶしかないな!
Yep, she did say that. Doesn't that gonna show that Kuragai was lying? Clearly, Sagusa has been calling her by that name. Maybe that's why it bothered her so much, like, no, please stop calling me that. In fact, adding near at the end there probably makes it worse. Well, I don't really see what she's got to do with this. As soon as she said it, she raised her hand, turning to Kuragai's side seat.
Hanego! Riki-kun-ga! Teine!
The seat was empty, only a book was left on the desk.
Kono ageta hidarite wa dou sureba ii no?
Put it back down? You can just put it down, even Riki agrees.
ゆいね、どうするんだろう。遅刻しちゃうじゃん。
Ah, so you do understand the concept.
仕方ないな。私がゆいねの代わりに。
She sat in Kurogai's sound seat.
これでバッチリじゃない？よし。少年、とりあえずアヒョーとかウヒャーとか叫んで私を楽しませてくれ。
That's clearly her impression of Kurogai, and I have a feeling she's probably gonna walk in any moment now. She began impersonating her. No, I won't.
何？仕方ない。この私自らアヒョーとかウヒャーとか叫んで楽しもう。アヒョーウヒャー。ふぅ。姉ごともあろうこの私が思わず全力で楽しんでしまった。
楽しそうだな。
There she is.
楽しい。なぜなら私のおっぱいはボインボインだ。
God.
いいよ。どう見てもそれほどではないわ。
で、
But is she talking about Sayusa herself? About a certain Kurogane son made her appearance.
ありゃあ、姉子。
人の席の周りで何の騒ぎだ、これは。
お席を温めておいてござる。
You know, wouldn't it, I don't know. I feel like the fact, I mean, look at these two. It's not about, you know, who has bigger breasts or whatever. It's how...It is, you know, she's got it, you know, all proper like that. She's like, cleavage. Just let it hang loose. Would that be a dress code violation? I feel like it would.
迷惑。
へえ、だってリキ君が帰れって私をいじめるんですよ。
Hold on, I just meant you'd be late otherwise.
ナオエさんがそんなことを言ったですか？
Don't misunderstand too.
いいだろう別に。M っ気のあるリキ君には朝から嬉しいイベントじゃないか。
I'm no masochist, not the tiniest bitch.
お、リキすげえな。朝っぱらから両上腕に頭筋に花か。
No way, I don't ever want to be in such a creepy situation. As usual, rowdy morning. The first bell jar.
リキ君が構ってくれないから。帰る。
She's not my route, so he doesn't care. She hung her head dejectedly. As she was about to leave the classroom, she looked at me. She was waving her hand. I had no other choice but to wave back. She winked at me and disappeared from sight. You know what she reminds me of? Really, it should be the other way around, because I played Dark Harbor 2 years after I played Little Busters. Was her name Nanaka or something like that? The pink-haired girl.Kind of got similar vibes from both characters, and it's not just the hair color. In fact, they have the same eye color, if I recall, as well. They have that same, similar kind of upbeat personality. Man, what a hopeless person.
じゃあ、今日はここまで。
That is not how I expected this guy to sound.
Eat it!
Just as soon as class came to an end, the classroom sprung back into life. Kumai-san, being on day duty, began cleaning the blackboard.
Hello!
It's like, don't sing at me like that. She's like, what was that? It's like, you're unfamiliar with my evil blackboard voice. It's the blackboards responding to that. that was makes it sound like that actually happened. And she's like,Hey, did the blackboard just talk to me? Her hand stopped moving. It looked like she couldn't reach the top. She's probably pretty short. I imagine all of the... Well, maybe Kurogai would be a bit taller. But I imagine all the other girls are like, really short. But Kud, I think she's actually under 5 foot. Which is really short. She stood on tiptoes, but still couldn't reach.I should help her. I mean, Riki doesn't look like he's particularly tall either. So Masato and Kengo are like, and probably Kyousuke as well, tower over him. I stepped forward. Boing! She tried to jump, but too much strength into it, crashing into the backboard. Watch where you're going, you dumbass!Well, she blew the landing, banging her head on the teacher's desk. Whoa, you okay? The whole classroom turned their attention to us.
Daijoubu, Kamikita-san.
We were at classmates who were voicing their concern.
Itai kedo heki.
It didn't really sound like he was okay at all. Shouldn't push yourself so hard. If you asked me, I would have helped.
Mommenasai.
And how tall would the top of that blackboard be? Rin. I mean, you can't really gauge how tall the door is, but, you know, that'd be easy enough to, you know, reach the top of that. But then again, I don't know, maybe she's really is just that short. Look at this guy, he's like, come on, man, give me the thing. And he's like, no. She let out a big sigh. Rin. She approached the blackboard in silence and picked up an eraser. Well enough, she made a jump and swiftly erased the remaining letters. Well, Rin must be kind of short as well.
Rin-chan, arigato!
Yeah, I said this before. I think I'm about 6 foot, but I'm not 100% sure on that. I remember one time, there's like, at this place called Folly Farm right here in Wales. And there was like this measuring thing next to like a giraffe to see how tall you are in comparison to a giraffe, and I was apparently about around 6 foot. That was the last time that any of that. I mean, I've always been kind of tall, but you know, as I got older, I felt like that people taller than me still and all that, which is obvious, but you know, it's kind of whatever. What is it? And it just makes me think, you know, back when you're a kid. Unless you've got like gigantism or whatever that's called, you're probably gonna be short for a while, but you know, gradually get taller, or you know, end up just staying short. You know, I remember like childhood memories of like looking up at the Christmas tree. Nowadays, I look at the Christmas tree because it's on level with my eyesight. It's like, I wouldn't even need to lift my hand much, if at all, to reach the top of the tree. The bell on her head chimed as she dashed off into the corridor.
また逃げられちゃった.
Well, I'm sure she's just embarrassed. She's not used to this kind of thing.
そうなのか. でも, ちょっと嬉しいな.
Huh?
手伝ってくれたから.
Yeah, I guess Rin was putting some effort into it, in her own way. You're right, that's a good idea. If it was Kamari-san, perhaps she would, in her own clumsy way, manage to change Rin's shyness. Now then, where did Rin go? Now this is the choice, right? Yeah, interestingly enough, after this choice, there's only one other choice of relevance for this route. That's right, she had completed another task after all. That being the case, another one might have arrived. I headed for the passageway. There she was talking to her cats. Let's once again watch.
Migi, migi, hidari, migi, migi, hidari!
This is like, I used to right and left in Japanese. I remember learning the difference between right and left in Japanese. Migi's right, right? Hidari's left. Migi's right. A swarm of cats had gathered in one corner of the courtyard. I didn't read that yet. What is she up to? She was sitting on one knee and swinging around a stalk of bristle grass.
もう一回行くぞ。右右左右左右。
Meow meow. The cat swallowed along with the bristle grass motion. Meow. Swipe.
引っかかったらダメだろ、お前。
Perhaps because she changed direction in the end, the striped cat tumbled over. Meow, roll, roll.
そしてもうどうでもよくなってるだろう。
Meow. One of them snatched the bristle grass away from her.
なんだ、やる気か?シュッシュッ。
Right, right, left, right, left, and a right uppercut. Wait, where'd the uppercut come into play? Meow, meow, meow. Cat tumbled over again.
お前らに学習能力はないのか?
Roll, roll.
やっぱりどうでもよくなってるんだろう。
She sighed with her hands on her hips.
いいけど、続きやるから返せ。
Now.
こら、逃げるな、バカ!
The cat, in the effort to get away from her, ran into a crowd of sleeping cats. Meow. Suddenly the courtyard filled with noise.
Shippo.
Of course, she removed a scrap of paper from the cat's tail and unfolded it. She looked at it carefully, walked up to her and, squatting down, placed my hand on the cat. You're doing great just now. So, more instructions showed up. She was so lost in her thoughts, she didn't appear to have heard me at all. Whoever sent this, aren't they from our school? I ventured my own guess. They've all been about the school and concerning school-related matters. Senator's probably using you because he or she can't deal with those problems on their own. Well, that still doesn't explain everything, though. Anyway, I'm sure it's someone who's seriously concerned about the problems at the school. So, what's this say this time?
Miro.
She handed me the scrap of paper. Heal 2A1 from lovesickness. What? Is it a class? Such shoddy instructions this time. Looked at Rin at her innocent childish face. Rin, do you know what lovesickness is?
マカにした口調だな。それぐらいわかるぞ。
That's fine then. Well, maybe she picked it up from manga or TV dramas. Problem number one is finding out who this 2A1 is.
まあ、2の A ってのはクラスだろうな。
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. Oh, you're on fire today, Rin. So what about the number one afterwards?
2の A1。つまり、A1 というやつだ。
Japanese internet variations that replaces parts of Japanese names with symbols, signs, and letters, and numbers. Other examples of this kind of wordplay include Keiichi as K1 and Katsue as CO2A. That's kind of a weird one, isn't it? Whose name may ring a bell if you've been following Ki. An English example of the same idea is M8 for mate. Well, yeah. It's basically, you know, when you're being a bit lazy and just can't be bothered to write it out, so you just go, mate. See? Sounds like eight, so therefore eight. I don't know, I can't remember if I ever did anything like that. Because when I write, I try to, you know, just write the words how they're supposed to be, rather than, you know, taking shortcuts. Also, what did it say there? Is K1 and Katsue as Kota. Kotua. Would that be pronounced as? He's like, what's your name? May ring a bell if you've been following Ki. It doesn't quite ring a bell, should it? Is it anything to do with planet or canon? Or maybe air? Otherwise, I haven't got a clue. Also, K1 never Keiichi. Wasn't Keiichi in. Higurashi, wasn't it that one baseball dude, didn't he call him like K-something? I don't think it was K-1, though. I think he just called him K. He's like, yeah, K, you're on a roll, buddy! Oh man, I just thought you were sounding reliable, but I'm a bit worried now.
なんだ、この推理に問題があるのか?
るいは具合でも悪いのか？
Of course, it's the former.
問題があるのか？
Well, if we followed your reasoning, we'd be overlooking the two altogether.
じゃあ、2年の A1 君だ。私は A1 君を探し出す。
Hey, you're going to search all the second year classes? Fell in her hair charm once and she dashed off. She'll be okay. I waited a little and followed after her. I found Rin standing in front of the faculty office.
Riki, 困った。
What's wrong?
先生に出席簿を借りて、A1 君を探してみたんだが、2年にはいなかったんだ。3年にはいたんだ。その A1 君だろうか。
Well, I doubt it. Say, Rin, why don't you listen to my theory?
ん？なんだ？正解がわかってるのか？
Maybe. 2A is a class number, and that much is pretty clear. As for the problem of the number 1, I think it's gotta be the number on the class attendance list. That was loud. She was profoundly shocked.
その発想はなかったな。
Well, it didn't occur to me either. I mean, I put two and two together for the, it being the class, but didn't really think of what the one could be.
でも、正しいと思う。
See?
よし、2の A に移動だ。
Sorry, but we haven't got time. I have my cell phone and check the clock. As I did, the bell rang.What a weird yawn. Thanks to all the practices we've had recently, I was constantly worn out and felt very tired in class. My cell phone was vibrating, a text message. I'm going to be doing class. I was curious, but I'd get in trouble if I was caught. I'd check it anyway. Wait, no, I clicked on the wrong one. No, I'll check after class. I resume taking notes from the blackboard for now. I just thought the one highlighted in green would be the one, but nope.
じゃあ、早いが、今日はこれまで。
Yeah, you've already left the room, teacher. Unusual though it may be, class was over before the bell rang. It's over. I stretch and remember the text message from earlier. I should check it out. Sender, Yuiko Kuragai, subject, no subject.Message, I'm free now, so let's do something fun. She seemed awfully free, all right. Well, I would have chose it, but I went with the one highlighting green. I thought it was gonna be the one to check it, but it wasn't. I didn't read it. Well, it's not something you should do during class.
Yui-chan, nani are?
ゆいちゃんと呼ぶのはやめてくれ。
What's wrong is we're nearly up to 2 hours on this recording. So that'll do for this record session. Probably have 3 parts out from this, and it'll probably be close to 2 weeks till the next record session if it's anything like this. So yeah. Oh yeah, might as well save.They make their debut appearance.As a save file. So let's go back to that. We've got Kyousuke, Masaru, Rin, Masaru, Kurigaya, and Komari. Masaru has got everyone beat on appearances there. Anyways, see you next time, viewers. See you next time.